just a typical family living in a typical neighborhood.
Some plan to have children, while to others it comes as a surprise.
You remember that time we played one-on-one, didn't have a goalie, and we bowled a strike?
Wait, are you pregnant?
Seriously, that made sense to you?
Either way, the long pregnancy process helps you get prepared for your little bundle of joy. Children come into this big, scary world defenseless and dependent on us. But now what? What is our job as parents?
I don't know that one.
To lead you in the right direction as you grow up?
To keep the house clean and wash the dishes. Make sure I be good on the bus and I don't go under the seats or go across the seats.
Mostly mom's job is home is cleaning the house.
It is.
Well, cleaning the kitchen. That's cool.
What about dad's?
Okay, dad's job. I don't really know if dad has a job in the house.
After long consideration, I've come to the conclusion that our job as parents is to teach rules, consequences, and expectations in the family, as well as in the community. It is also our job as parents to help mold these little creatures into caring, productive, well-rounded members of society. So we start on this first day by showing them that we will take care of their needs, keep them safe, and that we love them by nurturing them. While there are many people that contribute to the raising of a child, it is the parents that typically decide what type of authority they will enforce on their children's behaviors. Research shows that how we parent depends a great deal on how we were parented. Will you repeat the styles of your parents, or will you change the cycles to improve the outcomes? A question I had to consider. So I began this exhilarating, terrifying, and perplexing task of raising my babies. I didn't know exactly how I would parent differently than my mom, but I knew that there was room for improvement. I was raised in the spare the rod, spoil the child era. Yes, back in the day when it was still acceptable for teachers to give students a hack in school, so you can imagine how it was at home.
I go into timeout.
Go to my room.
Okay, presently we get to get a spanker.
I was convinced that it was unnecessary to spank children to make them behave, and I felt that if you just had enough patience, you could reason with your child, and everyone would understand and obey the expectations. Then my sweet little baby turned two. I quickly learned that I needed to establish more stringent rules, boundaries, and consequences. He was feisty and independent and challenged me from a very young age. So I had some decisions to make. What I found out in parenting my children is that some toddlers do not know, or maybe they just don't care, about reasoning and consequences. In my experiences, saying things like, "Please don't flush your toys down the toilet," or "Do not push your brother's head under the water," was very ineffective. Toddlers are not mentally capable of reasoning because these skills are not yet developed. I agree that kids will be kids, and we should let them work things out, but it was my job to ensure that he did not drown his brother or get hit by a car. And quite frankly, there comes a time when enough is enough. Teaching these acceptable behaviors can sometimes be as simple as modeling or discussing a natural consequence.
Sometimes when I do good chores, they take me out to get fun stuff.
Spankings do not need to be very hard to be effective and get kids' attention. Sometimes kids just need to know that you mean business.
And she gets me a spank on the butt after I be bad.
So there are four basic parenting styles that are common today. There's the authoritarian parenting. This parent has strict rules and you had better follow them or you may be grounded for life or even longer. These parents have high demands and are not responsive to their children's nurturing needs. Research shows that the authoritarian parenting style makes children behave out of fear. It is strict and children are not expected to disagree with their parents. These children become reliant on the voice of authority and are unable to develop a sense of independence.
Becca had these amazing plans for herself. I had such high expectations. She was always
perfect.
Yeah.
Maybe that's why she was afraid to tell you.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Then there's the authoritative parent who has rules and consequences, but you might just be able to reason with this one a time or two. I wouldn't suggest using the excuse that there was a train more than once, though. Those parents, they catch on quick. Some argue that the authoritative parenting style is best, that it results in a child that is happy, capable, successful, and well-adjusted. This style consists of boundaries and consequences, as well as nurturing. Next is the permissive parent. These parents are generally nurturing, but have little demands and expectations. You'll probably get to make your own curfew. Sometimes they're referred to as the best friend type parent. And finally, there's the uninvolved parent. I have kids. Huh, never knew. Can you give a child too much love? In my opinion, that is impossible. But you can give a child too much leniency and control. This is a permissive and maybe the uninvolved parenting style. You know, the one where the child makes the rules. Everyone knows that kid, the spoiled rotten one that no one wants to be around. If kids are acting like this at a young age, it's scary to think of how they'll be when they are teens and their entire existence revolves around breaking away and being defiant. They might turn out incapable of regulating emotions, be easily upset, high-strung, and intense in their reactions. Rules are put in place for our safety and the safety of others. These rules will always be governed by external forces. If we teach children that important rules are negotiable, we're doing them no favors. Trouble will find them eventually. I feel it's better to be taught by someone who loves you rather than a stranger who judges based only on your offense, because either way, the teaching will come. We cannot be by our children's side at all times. This is why we need to give them a strong foundation from the start, between what is right and what is wrong, not so much what is negotiable. It is important to keep in mind that cognitive development is not complete until the late teens to early 20s, so mistakes will be made. It's part of the learning process.
Hey, Beck, can I ask you a question? Mm-hmm. How did the whole with the, how did that happen?
Well, I was dating someone and we broke up. I was really hurt. My friends, they were like, oh, you should just have a meaningless fling, get over it, which is not something that I do, ever.
No, me either. I never did. Go on.
They point out this guy who's nice and definitely hot. Drinks were involved, precautions were not taken, and here I am, floating for two.
At the end of the day, I feel it is our job to raise happy, healthy, respectful children while protecting them and standing by their side as they jump through the hurdles of life. The joys of parenthood. I can't wait to see how they raise their kids.